Australia is known as the lucky country. And now a new study by the Australian Bureau of Statistics proves that we are indeed. It asks the question, is life getting better? And pretty much across the board it is. Social analyst Mark McCrindle joins us now to take a look at this study. Mark, good morning to you.
Good morning, Deb.
I know you've got a bit of the rain about on the Gold Coast and in parts of Sydney today, but it is looking blue skies and bright, really, for Australia across a range of areas. Very positive for us, comparing our situation from 10 years ago. Today, we're in good shape.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, there are a few clouds, certainly, but you know, this Australian Bureau of Statistics report they put out regularly to look at how we're travelling. It's the nation's report card, if you like, and it looks at the social, the economic, the environmental, the governance perspective of Australia. They use a dashboard method, so green for where we're going well, red for where we've gone backwards, orange if we're holding steady. And I have to say there's a fair bit more green than red, so we're in pretty good shape overall.
Let's take a look at some of the areas the study found that our lives are getting better. First up, society and life expectancy, pretty clear, is improving. And particularly, Mark, if you're a bloke.
Yeah, that's right. The blokes are closing in on the women. Women still outliving men by, you know, 4.5 years. But in the last 10 years of time, we've added 2 years of life expectancy. That's the biggest measure of health, how we're going, and we're living longer than ever, pushing on 80 years at birth for a male, over 84 years of age for a female life expectancy. In the last 40 years of time, we've added 10 years of life, so we're living longer and longer. And another good measure of our social progress is our education. So 2/3 of Australians now have a qualification after completing school. In fact, 1/3 of Australians have a university degree. So we're doing better than ever in the education stakes as well.
We're doing better on the economy as well. We've now got more money to spend with our net disposable income on the rise, a higher standard of living today. But one area that we aren't doing so well in is the environment.
Yeah, that's right. Bit of a mixed report there. Greenhouse gas emissions are higher than they were 10 years ago, although we've got a bigger economy as well. But as far as a measure of how we feel about the built environment, green light there. More Australians are feeling that the road network and congestion is acceptable to them. Now, it's only about 1 in 4 that say it's acceptable. In cities like Sydney, it's quite low, but in cities like Canberra and Hobart, the majority of the population are happy with the road network. So built environment-wise, we're happy, but economically, particularly good, particularly when you keep in mind that we've had a global financial crisis in there. Productivity is a little bit down, but we're earning $10,000 more than we were a decade ago, so economically very good.
More money in the pocket. And the area of governance as well. A lot of people complained at the election that they were disgruntled with the political process and politicians in general, but more Australians are enrolled to vote than we were in previous years.
That's right. More than 9 in 10 Australians enrolled to vote. And while we sometimes don't like to complain about governments or government departments, the majority of Australians are happy with our governance and give it the thumbs up. So, yeah, good news on the governance side as well.
Let's keep those green marks coming as well. Blue skies indeed. Got on you, Mark. Thanks for your time this morning.